Mum and Dad started growing our interest in this stuff. I remember building things like little electronic Santa boards with light flashing lights. But it really, really started for me in around year five. I was part of an advanced group at school. We entered the Robocop dance competition.
And ever since then, we've been building little Shrek robots that picked up Fiona and took her away. Or we did Madagascar, where we danced to Mover it and our robot was in that. And every year, we'd come up with a new competition. I know we're still doing it.
I didn't really know what I wanted to study at school. I was good at maths and science, but I didn't want to do straight maths or science. A lot of people suggested to me that I try out engineering as an applied science and maths degree. Once I got here, I started to really like it.
I loved maths in high school, and I sort of saw programming as an application of the logic behind maths. I saw computer science as a way of being able to still do something that I really enjoyed, but be creative as well.
Think about the technology you use every day. It's in every aspect of our lives. And think about who are the people that are developing that technology. The statistics at the moment in terms of women's representation, it's really sad. I think girls have a unique opportunity to firstly be part of a great industry and actually be part of creating the future.
I think there are so few girls in engineering because girls are not encouraged to study science and mathematics when they're younger. I went to an all-girls school and there was only 10 or so girls in my physics and mathematics classes. Of these girls, about half of us are studying engineering now, but that doesn't make many.
The disparity between girls and boys in science and engineering is very deep-seated. If you look back to the toys that girls get, it's very gender-dominated. So it's something that society really needs to recognise, that girls have equal ability and can have equal interest in this area. And it's actually quite culturally specific, because in a lot of Asian cultures, girls going into ICT, for example, is seen as perfectly normal.
There probably weren't very many girls interested in IT because of the perceptions around it. Everyone thinks IT is just, let's learn to use Microsoft Word, and let's learn to use Microsoft Excel. Publisher and Excel, and we're going to make brochures for our IT class today. They don't actually realise what IT is.
You need strong people skills to work in computer science. You need to collaborate with other people a lot. Other programmers, other engineers, people who design user interfaces. You need to be able to communicate well. You can also work in a lot of different areas. You don't have to do programming if you don't want to.
To me, IT is one of the best things in the world. You're designing things, you're building things from scratch, you're working with other people in teams. Girls are definitely natural team members, team leaders, really, really good at organisation. You can see it. It's something that we do really well.
I think in practice, females are generally better at communicating, and this is a very big part of engineering in terms of dealing with the client and understanding the client's needs and turning them into what we actually need to design for them.
Design, interaction, and business analyst roles often attract females. When I was quite young, I just thought, IT, that's just writing code or building networks, but that's actually just a very small minority of it.
Engineering is a spectrum. It's not just the going out and building bridges. There's an enormous range of activities that it covers. There's lots of opportunities to make a difference. It can be in clean energy, it can be in biomedical engineering, it can be in creating greener chemical processes. There's lots and lots of ways to help the world using science and engineering.
Well, it's important for any industry to be balanced. Half of the users of any software system, of any computer, are gonna be females. So we can't really rely on men to just come up with the design for all computer systems. Females should have some input too.
My parents never really encouraged me to do computer science. It's not like medicine or law, they were kind of pushing me more into those areas, but I actually think that computer science is more like the new law these days. There are so many jobs, you can take it anywhere around the world. There's a lot of money in it, so I think my parents are quite happy with the choice that I made.
There is such demand for people in tech and engineering fields that we need every single one of you to think about coming into the industry and joining us.